And he told me a story of an Olympic athlete. At the Olympics, this is many years ago. So he's at the Olympics, and this athlete, who's proved himself, he's competing in 2 days. The coach did not like his round off or his cartwheel. So for practice, the 2 days prior, for 2 hours each day, he made him do his cartwheel over and over and over again, because it's one of the hardest things to learn. And it's amazing, Olympic level gymnast, he's there, he's made it, he's ready for the gold and he has to work on his round off and his cartwheel. That's how difficult this movement can be. Doesn't mean we can't learn it quickly, it takes a long time, there's flexibility involved. There are three rotations in a cartwheel. There's forward, there's sideways, and there's a y-axis rotation as well. We're twisting three ways. You might not realize it, but we're doing that. I'll show you later, I'll explain it more. But there are three rotations in this movement. There's a handstand component there. There's a hamstring component involved in this. We need to master all of them. So I'll show you a few to understand. And I'm gonna go right there, so watch out. So when you do kick up to a cartwheel, I go with my right leg, my back leg, my power zone. This one's pushing off. You're gonna be choosing either left leg or right leg. But it's gonna be starting in the lunge position, squared off hips, arms up overhead. What position am I in? Hollow body. As I reach forward and kick through, I finish in that same hollow body position. Doesn't matter if I'm going left or right, I'm still hitting that same position. Cool? Let's talk about on the blocks. These blocks are a training tool. You're gonna use them to kick over the block. You're gonna take it very simple, very basic. If I'm starting with my left leg, I'm gonna go at a bit of an angle. Nice big lunge. I'm gonna play a counting game. Left hand is one, two, three, four. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place my hands down, lift my legs over, one, two, three, four in that back lunge. I don't need to go very high. What this is teaching you to do is push through your shoulders and have this leg kick up and around. So even if it's on the right side or left side, doesn't matter. Approaching at an angle, nice big lunge, hands down, one, two, three, four. When I land, I want to stabilize my position. If I mess up, I'm going to teach my body where to land, hold it, and then go. Too many times we have an athlete, they kick out to that cartwheel, and they walk away. Cut, see you later. No, it's still going to develop bad habits. It's going to teach you how to leap. So lunge, hands down, kick up. Tack, tack, stay. Oh, my foot's not in the right position. There it is. So you will learn that movement faster. Does that make sense? Okay. That's it, Sam. And that lunge, pause it. Good work.
Yeah, right. Oh, we want our feet to go around.
I just want them to go around. I don't want them to go up. I want them to go around. So lunge. Kick up. Stand that lunge. Good. Wait, stay tight. We're going to go over the center of the mat. We're going to pretend that line is on top of the mat. That's where our hands are gonna start placing. When you go to that lunge, this line's gonna separate you. One foot on one side of the line, the other foot on the other side of the line. So I'm standing here, feet underneath my hips, step my leg back. I'm gonna aim down, my right hand goes first to my right leg. My left leg's first, left leg. What I'm gonna ask you to do is you're still gonna kick over. If you kick vertical, that's fine, but I still want you to kick over and land on that lunge. When you land, exact opposite. So I'm lunging, kicking. Notice how my feet landed on the exact opposite side, but still on that line. If you mess up, if you pull your foot over, correct it, say, okay, I want to land here. And do it again, one person at a time.
Hit that again. There's one thing that we need to fix before we move on to this, and you need to be cognizant of it. Do a perfect one. Look at his legs. Now do one with bent knees and shitty form. That ain't what we want. Don't make it quite so dramatic.
Okay.
Do it one more time. So if he comes over with a slightly bent knee. Just a slightly bent knee, yeah. That's not what I want, right? So go back to your drill on the end of it. That's why this drill is so important. Even if he's just hopping his hips and legs over, they're straight. This is how you teach someone to begin that movement. Well, his form is impeccable in the leg. Now do one over the top of it. And we let that transfer up. Don't let them get away with shitty movement. Make that leg straight and that toe point happen. Because when you start bringing this over your head, if you create an angle with the leg, that's now a counterweight. And it's also going to be a shitty landing. Make sense? Julie, anything you want to add?
So you're starting in your lunge. As you go over the top of that mat, keeping those arms up. Not one arm at a time, because that ends to the moving of the body, but keeping them right here, finishing in your strong lunge.
So stop right there. Look at your feet. Are they on the line? Right? That's to answer the question. Are they on the line?
No.
All right, so when I start my cartwheel, I don't want to be here and here. I want to be right here. Okay? Give it the power and take it all the way over. Not bad. Good. Now look at your feet. The feet landed properly. I just want to show you where your hands were. This side of the line. So if I look at you, I'm being critical here. If I look at you, I'm looking at, you know, where your hips are over your shoulder. No, they're over on this side. So don't think about turning anywhere but right down that line. So I don't want to turn that power to here or here. I want it right down the center where your feet are.
Michelle, can you hit that again? Let's see if you remember that. I want you guys to watch this. Watch Michelle's hands. This is getting a bit more advanced for cartwheel. We're no longer keeping those hands turned sideways, but we're having one hand turned upside down. That's the second hand. That finishes off the rotation. She did it naturally, and I like that. So let's watch her. She's going to nice big lunge. Wear those hips off. Kick over. Not bad. That's it. That's good work. Now, I'm going to do the same thing on the cartwheel. So you guys are going to see my hands when they place. That's why I put chalk on my hands. I'm going to big lunge as I kick up and over. That second hand places in line with that first hand. So, if you notice, I messed up my line a little bit. It wants to be a bit more. I know, Julie. You're getting mad at me. But the idea is that second hand, you're reaching forward. That second hand finishes the rotation. What we tell kids constantly is you're going through a hallway. You can't twist, but you have to go forward, then go through the hallway. So think about that when you're doing cartwheels. Even if it's left, that right hand's going to come over and on top. Make sense? Okay. Let's start doing that, and we're going to...
So what else can we do? Well, we can put hands on the ground. That's where your hands are going to go. We can place where your feet are going to go, right? Or you can take a chalk line and put it on the ground. Lots of ways to get hand placement. Or we use the line itself. So, let's earn lunch today. What is this? No, it's not. It's just a 4-inch line. 4-inch width line is all it is. What's this down here? Same damn thing. The only difference is this one's slightly elevated. Now we'll have an exit strategy on this that as you come over, if you think you can't land your feet on it, well, we can just go to a straddle and we can straddle the beam, right? But we have to do what? Stay active with everything we do. Julie, just give us one cartwheel.
Oh, Lord. Pressure.
Not bad. So let's say that she's not going to make contact. She can come over several different ways. We'll watch her here. Now, she does want to go wide with the leg, right? Because if not, you'll make contact, you won't enjoy it. Any other exit strategy you want to show?
Yeah. If you're just not going to make it at all, because I know that going straight over the top on this balance beam feels so extreme compared to what you're doing on the floor. You're going to think you're going straight down the line, but you're really way out here in the ocean. And if you are way out there in the ocean, you just finish your cartwheel, just like you did in your timers.
And to learn to earn lunch today, that's acceptable. All right, that is acceptable. So show that one more time. So if you're landing, let's just go with just coming over and landing in the ocean. We've landed in the ocean, we've landed in water, we're safe. Or we can come over, you want to make contact with the beam, make contact with the beam, and we'll go have lunch. All I need is one. I'll take it. I'm proud of you.
Right.
Not bad. Not bad.
I'm not nervous. I just normally do this.
Just like they taught you.
Not bad. Nice. Nice.
That was your business.
You ruined those times.
Hello.
Nice. Nice. And so you only missed it by that much. I mean, but you're landing in the ocean. That's great. Come on, Special K.
Walk your hands down there and do like some dramatic double back like this.
Nice!